everyone. I'm Dr. Rizwana, working as a professor of physics in Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Today, we are going to discuss about what is the difference between classical mechanics and quantum physics and what led to origin of quantum mechanics. Here, so when we were talking about quantum physics, completely we talk about energy levels, quantized energy levels. Whereas when we are talking about classical mechanics, we talk about continuous energy levels. Now in this video, we are going to see like classical physics we can apply to which type of bodies, as well as quantum physics can be applied to what type of bodies. So moving further, first we'll try to compare classical and quantum physics. Now, first, when we are talking about classical physics, so this classical physics completely talk about real objects and their motion in real space. So here, we can make out energies associated with the real objects and of course their motion in real space using classical mechanics. Whereas coming to quantum theory, here in this case, we study about very precise observations here. Or we can keep it like a classical mechanics, it comes in bulk, whereas quantum mechanics, it comes to atomic dimensions. So when we are talking about atoms and their atomic dimensions, then comes our quantum theory. And here, key difference is that if you take classical physics, it assumes that objects are real. So here it will assume that real objects exist, and usually we'll study about those real objects. Whereas when we are talking about quantum physics, as we have seen that quantum theory, it studies about very precise observations. So here, those observations, it should be repeatable. So it will consider only those observations which are repeatable. And of course, here also they are real. And here in this case, they start their theory by considering those observations as if they are of anything. So by taking that repeated observations into consideration, quantum physics is postulated. Now if we take this classical mechanics, it is applied for macroscopic objects. So what do you mean by microscopic objects? Where we are talking about objects in bulk. So that can be spacecraft, planets, stars and galaxies. Here we talk about non-relativistic motion of celestial bodies like planets, stars and galaxies. So here objects we are dealing, they are in macro or they are really huge bodies. And in classical mechanics, and this classical mechanics, it is also called as Newtonian mechanics, and it provides extremely accurate results. So in this case, there is no approximately. Here we'll talk only about accurate results, as long as domain of study is restricted to large objects. As we know that classical physics, it can be applied only for large objects, and when we are dealing with the large objects, then it will give us accurate results when we are going for this classical mechanics. And here also, when we are talking about speeds, here we'll talk about non-relativistic speeds. So here the speeds involved, they do not approach speed of light. So everything are real observations when we are talking about classical mechanics. So whichever body we take into consideration, here the speeds will not go beyond speed of light. So here we'll say that speeds do not approach speed of light. Another thing is, here we are talking about accurate results. And also, when we talk more about these classical theories, what you say here is main disadvantage of classical mechanics is when you try to apply them to extremely small particles, or when we go for very small dimensions like atomic dimensions or micro dimensions, and here these small particles, they have this property of traveling with very high speed. So when we are talking about their motion of such particles going with very high speed, then this classical theory, it is going to fail. So here we cannot give our accurate results, and here also we cannot talk about their accurate speeds. So this classical mechanics, it has got its own advantages because of its accurate in results, and here it talks about realistic speeds, but whereas it fails when we are talking about very small particles. So in order to overcome this problem, we have this quantum mechanics, and of course quantum mechanics, it can be applied not only to micro or small bodies, but also it can be applied to macro bodies also. And here, when we take this quantum mechanics, it provides accurate results for particles which are of very, very small sizes. And this quantum mechanics, it handles wave particle duality of atoms and molecules. So here this quantum mechanics, it deals with a particle exhibiting dual characteristic. So it will exhibit both as wave as well as particle. And if you take Einstein, main role behind this quantum mechanics is played by scientist Einstein. And if we consider special theory of relativity given by Einstein, so we know that it deals with particles of very small sizes, whereas if we consider general theory of relativity, it studies about particles in general. So here we can also take particles which are in macroscopic range. So here we can say that, of course, when we go for classical mechanics, it is applicable only for macroscopic huge bodies. Whereas when we come to quantum mechanics and when we are talking about properties exhibited by very small particles, there comes our quantum mechanics, which take dual characteristic property to explain behavior of small particles, atoms or molecules. And also here we can go for particles of larger size also when we want to apply this quantum mechanics. Now, here, as we already told, that classical mechanics, it explains the motion of celestial bodies like planets, stars, microscopic and microscopic bodies, and all of them, they are moving with non-relativistic speeds. And here speed does not approach speed of light. But when it comes to atomic dimensions, when we are talking about atomic dimensions, like when we are talking about speeds or motion of electrons, protons or neutrons, so this classical theory is going to fail. And there are certain phenomena, like when we are talking about stability of atoms, also when we are talking about spectral distribution of black body radiation, or when we are talking about discrete spectra of atoms, or we are talking about certain phenomena like photoelectric effect, Compton effect or Raman effect. Here we cannot explain all these phenomena based on classical theory, and this classical theory talks about continuous energy levels. So where a particle or a body, it can take any energy level from 0 to infinity. So if we consider that concept, then we will not be able to explain all this particular phenomena. Okay, we cannot explain stability of atoms. We cannot explain why black body, when we heat a black body, why it is going to emit, why it is a good emitter and why it is going to emit spectral distribution of radiation of different frequencies or different wavelengths. And also there are certain phenomena like photoelectric effect and Compton effect, where we have to explain those phenomena based at very atomic dimensions, or where we are going to talk about interaction between the particles. So when we take these phenomena, our classical theory is going to fail. And this insufficiency of classical mechanics, it has led to the development of quantum mechanics. And when we talk about quantum mechanics, the first thing that comes to our mind is quantum numbers, where atomic system, it has been explained based on different quantum numbers, and these different quantum numbers, they give rise to discrete energy levels. So here, as we are comparing classical mechanics with quantum mechanics, so here what you will say, and of course, as we told that quantum mechanics, here main this quantum term, it came from this quantum numbers. And when we talk about different quantum numbers, here we have one principal quantum number n, and depending upon values of this principal quantum number, we have energy levels, and those energy levels, they are called as discrete energy levels. So when we talk about classical mechanics, we talk about continuous energy levels, where energy varies from 0 to infinity. But when we talk about quantum mechanics, where we are dealing with atomic system or particles of very small sizes, then you will observe that energy levels, they are well separated from each other, and each energy level, it is for one particular value of this principal quantum number. So for different values of this principal quantum number, will have different values of energy levels. And as you can see that these energy levels are well separated from each other, and only for certain particular values of n, we are going to have certain particular values of energies. And here concept of having energy levels from 0 to infinity, we cannot take into account. This particular explanation, we are able to explain many phenomena using this quantum mechanics. Like suppose when we are talking about photoelectric effect. So we know that this particular photoelectric effect, which was given by Einstein, in this photoelectric effect, what we'll do, we'll take a metal surface. So on that metal surface, suppose we have taken a metal surface, and this metal surface, when it is exposed to high frequency radiation, when radiation falls on this metal surface, then we'll observe that across this metal will have flow of current. So when we keep an ammeter, there will be flow of electrons or flow of current. And why is it so? Here we talk about the interaction between two particles. So here we are talking about a phenomena taking place at atomic dimension. So here what we'll observe here is our light radiation, which is made up of photons, which are particles. They interact with electrons of metal surface, and because of interaction between photons of light radiation and electrons of metal surface, that's why we are going to have this current. And similarly, when we talk about Compton effect, so what is Compton effect in this case? Here also, when high frequency radiations like X-rays, when we make them fall on certain surfaces, certain solid surfaces, then the scattered X-rays from this particular scatterer, when we observe those scattered radiations, then we'll observe that there are two types of scattered radiations. One scattered radiation, it is called modified. Another one, it is called as unmodified. In unmodified, this radiation, scattered radiation, it is going to have same frequency and wavelength as incident radiation. Whereas, if you consider modified scattered radiation, its energy or frequency, it is less compared to incident radiation. And why there is like a change in energy? Again, here we talk about interaction between photons of light radiation and electrons of scatterer. And this highly energetic photon, it gives its energy to when it is giving its energy to electron, so obviously what happens to this photon, it is going to lose energy. And that photons which are giving energy or which are undergoing inelastic collisions, they'll give rise to modified scattered radiation. And similarly, we can explain about Raman effect, and also we have our black body radiation as given by Planck's, and this Planck's postulate completely depends upon discrete energy packets known as photons. So radiation, it consists of atomic oscillators, and those atomic oscillators, they are called as photons, which have discrete energy levels and whose energies they are given as En is equal to nh nu. And we know that black body, it is a good absorber as well as good emitter. So when we heat a black body, or whenever light radiation interacts with matter in case of black body, that interaction, it is in terms of these discrete packets or particles known as photons. And here what you will observe here is, when we heat a black body, so depending upon temperature, radiations that are going to come out of that particular black body, they'll form a spectrum. And that explanation is also given in terms of photons of light radiation. And here main quantum mechanics, here it is going to take dual characteristic, both behavior as a wave as well as the particle. So that's why many phenomena at atomic dimensions we are able to explain in quantum mechanics by considering these discrete energy levels, or where we say that all energies are not allowed, but only certain particular values of energies are allowed. So that's why, so this is how this inefficiency of this classical mechanics, it has led to the development of quantum mechanics. So we have come from continuous energy levels to discontinuous energy levels, and having that discontinuous energy levels is nothing but quantization of energy. So with this, I'm going to finish my video here. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.